Is Celtic Mate, and then Balladur followed another length and a half away. Mr. Mercutio, Bit Tiddly second last, and bringing up the rear is Oba Oba. King View in front, 600 left to run, a length on the favourite Filatimo. Travelling third is Manelli from Ruemba. Off the track is Lara used a couple to Patch Adams, and then Celtic Mate. Over on the inside is Mont Blanc Magic, and then a gap of a length, the Balladur, Bit Tiddly, Mr. Mercutio, and Oba Oba. Straightening by the 400, Filatimo serves it up to King View. Lara used coming home solidly on the outside. Ruemba's under the whip, Manelli trying to get clear, and Patch Adams heads the others. It's Filatimo almost level with King View. Lara used the outside, and Manelli trying to go for the split. Forget the others. King View in front on the outside. Lara is coming at King View, but King View looks to the naked eye to have won at a nostril. Larius and Manelli didn't have a lot of luck. Followed by Filatimo, Patch Adams, and then came at the head of the others. Bit Tiddly in company there with Balladur. Further back in the run was Ruemba, and then Mont Blanc Magic, and the last three home were Mr. Mercutio, Celtic Mate, and Oba Oba. Photo. King View and Larius. Not be much in this as the line has been reached. Looks like King View has just been able to score on the freeze. By Fairy King. And is trained by Gay Waterhouse and Lara Use. Number five by Brief Truce. Trained by Ronnie Quinton and ridden by Hugh Bowman. Four and five are in the photo finish for first in race number four. So there won't be much in this when the judge has a look. Oh, gee, that longer shot is certainly out emphasising the outside horse. When you have a look at the longer shot here, the outside horse is much closer than it appears to the naked eye, so hang on to your tickets on the two of them here. 4-5, 5-4. Desperately close finish. Time for the race was 1:24.36. 34.90, and the winner is number four. Number four is the winner, and that is King View, ridden by Glenn Boss. Looked to win to the naked eye, and it's just scored by, as the photo finish appears on our big screen here in field, an absolute pimple. Number four, King View, is the winner, 590 and 190. Second goes to number five, Lara Use, Hugh Bowman, 270. Number six, Manelli, Dan Beasley, for Max Crockett, 360. Number one ran fourth, Filatimo, 3270, Quinella. $53 exacta, $603.30 the trifecta, the extra double, $37.10, and the first four, 4561, $1,564.40. We're waiting for the superfecta in full, and here they come, the numbers, 456172, 456172. Gee, there's a bit of action out in the horses running about fourth, fifth and sixth with about 150 to go. And a couple of them were all over the shop. The winner, King View, has had the two runs back from a spell for the two wins raced by G.G. Peterson, the Chloros Syndicate, and that's G.E. and M.G. Chloros and T.J. Bodle, trained by Gay Waterhouse, ridden by Glenn Boss. 1:24.36, 34.90 was the sectional time. Waiting on Superfecta News 1 or otherwise, as Glenn is about to unsaddle. Right, let's check those totes as the horses are coming up elsewhere. Gold Coast, in fact, Superfecta declared dividend $29,671 and a few cents, but Les will tell you the carryover shortly. Margins, winning margin there was a nose with 3/4 second and the third, a nose 3/4. Right. 590, 190, number 4, 270, number 5, 360, number 6, 3270, Quinella, $53 exacta, $37.10, the 7 and 4 extra double, $603.30 was the trifecta.
Off at the coast.
Okay.
And Senator Diva both showing pace shortly after the break. And there goes Kieran Lady.
Classic Prince, 270 win, two even a place.
Race 4, Newcastle, 1 custody, 24 and
40.
Stalls back there racing, and Nautilism and Les Vosruller left quickly with Bill Tim, and just behind them now is Loose Truth, followed by Mr. Classical. Coming down towards the first, they fly over it and out wide here. Les Vosruller had the lead from Bill Tim and Nautilism, Loose Truth and Mr. Classical from Classic Prince. Further back, Prince Lemaire on the outside of a Bold Impulse and three last of all, Real Zeal. Pretty good pace in the early point. There are three along the back here, and the leader is Les Vosroulis going out about three or four lengths in front of Built Him. A length for the back, Mr. Classical. Nautilism a little wide, three deep around Loose Truth and Mr. Classical. Two lengths for the back is Classic Prince as they come along towards the next. Two lengths to Bold Impulse, and they're followed by Prince Lemaire, and two lengths to Real Zeal last of all. Going down the back on the first round, there's another one coming up at the 900 on the first circuit. Les Vosroulis out three lengths in front from Built Him as they go over that one. Nautilism went up third, a length for the back, Mr. Classical. Nautilism now one off the fence, a length and a half then to Loose Truth is on the outside of Classic Prince, and then Prince Lemaire followed by Bold Impulse, and two lengths last of all Real Zeal. Coming around the top circle on the first round, and the leader here is Les Vosroulis, and he's out about two and a half lengths in front from in second placing Built Him. Two lengths further back, Mr. Classical. Nautilism a half away fourth. Two lengths further back, Classic Prince. Inside Loose Truth, a couple of lengths to Bold Impulse, who's covering up Prince Lemaire, and two to Real Zeal last of all. 2,300 metres to go, three flights down the straight on the first round in the Australian hurdle, and Les Vosroulis will come down towards the first of three in the lane here at the 300 metre mark, and here he comes to it. And he measured it okay, two lengths to Built Him from Nautilism. Loose Truth is now travelling forward up on the outside. Mr. Classical back on the fence. A length and a half to Classic Prince, Prince Lemaire, Bold Impulse and Real Zeal. Here's the next one below the 200 metre mark. Leader got over it in front, Les Vosroulis, but Loose Truth is striding up on the outside to join him. And coming down towards the judge with a lap to go, Loose Truth has gone up now to match strides with Les Vosroulis with a round to go. Two lengths to Built Him, a half Mr. Classical. Nautilism is up on the outside of Classic Prince as they measure that one at the 1800. Two lengths to Bold Impulse, followed by Prince Lemaire, and Real Zeal given a crack with a whip last of all as Loose Truth takes up the lead now. Out of the straight, 1,700 to go in the Australian hurdle. Loose Truth by two. Les Vosroulis second, a length further back, Built Him third. Mr. Classical fourth. Classic Prince in the middle, and he's pushing Nautilism a little wide. Nautilism starting to improve from Prince Lemaire back on the inside of Bold Impulse and two to Real Zeal. Les Vosroulis having a crack again at this leader, Loose Truth, and Les Vosroulis took it up again down the back of the 1,400. Five flights to get over in the Australian hurdle, and Les Vosroulis went a length in front of Loose Truth, three lengths to Build Him. Mr. Classical is fourth, the inside, Nautilism fifth. A half then to Classic Prince as they go to that one. Then Prince Lemaire outside of Bold Impulse and two lengths to Real Zeal. 1,100 to go, and it's Les Vosroulis with Loose Truth back on the inside. They go to that together. Four lengths in front of Nautilism to third around Built Him. A length and a half to Classic Prince. Looks to be travelling all right on the back of Nautilism at the 1,000-metre mark. He goes back to the rail to try and improve. Over that next one they go. He lost a bit of ground, Classic Prince, and Les Vosroulis got three-quarters in front from Loose Truth, a length into Nautilism. Now Classic Prince pulls to the outside, fourth on the outside of Built Him at the 800. Two lengths to Bold Impulse and further back Real Zeal, Mr. Classical and Prince Lemaire. Coming down towards the 700-metre mark, Les Vosroulis in front. Nautilism going after him quickly. Loose Truth under pressure and Classic Prince went to third. Bold Impulse running on and further back Built Him. Two flights to get over, 550 out. Nautilism hit the front on the turn now. Moved away from Les Vosroulis. Classic Prince called on, goes after Nautilism, 400 to go. Two flights out, the favourites are going to draw away and fight it out. Nautilism leaving the fence, back on the inside. Classic Prince hooks off his heels, comes to the outside. He's after this leader, Nautilism. There's not much between them with one flight to go. Nautilism and Classic Prince on terms on the outside. Here's the last in the Australian hurdle. Nautilism scrambled through it. Classic Prince hit the lead. Oh, look at him draw away now. It's all over. The top weight coming away, Classic Prince. He's a good galloper. And he wins the Australian hurdle a length and a half to Nautilism. Game in defeat. Five away, third is Bold Impulse and then Built Him. A gap to Real Zeal, Les Vosroulis, followed by Loose Truth. Then Prince Lemaire, and last of all is Mr. Classical.
One Classic Prince, C. Durden, $2.30 and $1.30. Four Nautilism, $1.20. Two Bold Impulse, $1.90.
Almost set at Newcastle, Diamond Mac, the favourite at $3.90 to win, two even the place. Second pick is 11, Tears of an Eagle, $5.30 to win, $2.10 for the place. Stand down, one Classic Prince, $2.30, $1.30. Four Nautilism, $1.20. Two Bold Impulse, $1.90. Quinello, $4. Exacta, $9.10. 142 Trifecta, $18.90. And correct weight at the Gold Coast on race 4, 2, 1 and 3.
Now, Cafe Success is the last one to move into line. Cafe Success trained on the track by Phil Anderson. Cafe Success comes forward. Looks as though it's fairly fit for its first up to...
In a rather cantankerous frame of mind, Claxon. She might consent. Now, she gets her head and neck in, and the gatemen do the trick. So, 10 out of 10 to them yet again. And we're all set to see them fly in the Ingham Love 'em. Veloci, now owned by Mr. Del Duca. Drawn in gate two. Red light blinks away. Started ready, and they're off. Veloci was last out, and leaving Bess was Lady of Letters, Claxon in a hot pursuit, and third Klarzig from Secret Decree. Here's Mucca D'Amato driving up on the inside, and as they settle, it's Lady of Letters narrowly from Claxon, followed by Mucca D'Amato, Secret Decree, and then Klarzig and Funny Lass wide out. Stutter's pretty deep as well, followed by Veloci, and further away in the field then comes Beauty Way, Miss Doopsie, and Last Northern Music, a compact lot in the main. Down the side of the 650, Lady of Letters from Claxon, Mucca D'Amato's Secret Decree and Funny Lass ride it off the track from Klarzig. By G, the favourites covering a lot of additional ground. Stutter, Miss Doopsie on the inside, and then comes Veloci, followed by Beauty Way, and two lengths to Northern Music. They're homeward bound, and in the all lilac Lady of Letters rider, letting her have rein, and she skipped two lengths on Claxon. In the third spot, Mucca D'Amato's Secret Decree is fourth. Stutter's under the whip and has got four behind her, but Lady of Letters is giving a real sight, and down past the 175, Lady of Letters, three lengths, Claxon, Klarzig, followed by Miss Doopsie, and although she's tiring a little, Lady of Letters, she's going to have a big enough lead and win. Lady of Letters from Claxon, third posse going to Miss Doopsie and wide out Klarzig, and then Mucca D'Amato, Veloci, Stutter, Secret Decree, Beauty Way, Northern Music, and Funny Lass finished tailed off. Lady of Letters, number three, written by Darren Beatman in the All Lilac for Frank Gardner and owners Mrs. C. Higgs and D.R. Casson. And has paid $17 upwards on Tab Limited. $17 a win and $4.20 for the place. By Geiger counter from Bar Blur, having her 28th start today. Win 5, 6 seconds, 3/3. No numbers up at this point. Three Lady of Letters will be there. Number four gets second. And that is Claxon, ridden by Huey Bowman. And it has paid a dividend of $5.20. Number two, Miss Doopsie, Dan Beasley, has paid $3.10. So the numbers are 3-4-2 with 8, Klarzig the fourth. $17.80 for the winner. Now the Quinella is $117.20. Exacta $294.20. Trifecta $1,986.90. And the 3-4-2-8 first for $10,738 exactly. And the winner.
Set to go, race number five today. Stalls back racing. Modern General went back after the start. Joffa Gem missed it about a half length and jumping out quickly here. Chalet and Me with Comedy Court, Rouge Fur, and getting up on the inside, Inkamulla. Three or four in line in the early point. From further back then came Tsar Hero. Hot Touch followed the inside by Logical Reason. Further back, Multiple Magic, Mastic Deep. Around runs to win, three or four, then to Joffa Gem, right off the track, and last of all, Modern General. At the 800-metre mark, and Rouge Fur had the lead about a half in front of Chalet Ami, who's almost on terms of the leader. Two lengths to Inkamulla, third, one Comedy Court, fourth. Tsar Hero, fifth, and three deep a length, and to Logical Reason, the inside, Multiple Magic. Then Mastic, Joffa Gem, runs to win. Logical Reason lost its position back, second last, and four last of all is Modern General coming around the turn, and Chalet Ami well off the fence, a half length in front of Rouge Fur, a length and a half then, pulled to the outside, Inkamulla. Then Comedy Court runs to win from Tsar Hero and Mastic a mile off them. Chalet Ami ducked back to the fence. Inkamulla after it down at the 300 metre mark. Chalet Ami and Inkamulla. Inkamulla got its head in front of Chalet Ami. Two lengths to Comedy Court out in the middle, but Inkamulla took the lead with about 150 to go. Drew three lengths in front of Comedy Court. Multiple Magic runs to win, are running on well, but Inkamulla's home for Young Winks. Inkamulla by three lengths runs to win, a neck away third, Multiple Magic. Then Comedy Court, Rouge first, Chalet Ami. Mastic never came into it from Logical Reason, Hot Touch, Tsar Hero, Modern General, and Joffa Gem last of all.
10 Inkamulla, a double for Jay Winks. 1770, 430, six runs to win. 410, third five, Multiple Magic, 260. Gold Coast on the previous, two lengths by three quarters, time 110.60.
At the barrier at Newcastle for the fifth, and the favourite is
Grail to complete the line in the Aussie Home Loans Handicap, right on starting time, 3 o'clock Eastern Time. 2000 the journey. Mr. Waiting on the starter climbs his stand now. And they're off.
Immediately Goodwood drops out to last. Cries Le Mirage in front, but the rider doesn't want to be there, and Market Link obliges, goes up quickly to hit the lead. Holy Grail to second. Our Cracker working to third, and then Cries Le Mirage is just shading Our Cracker as I speak from Regal Alliance, Kugel Hopf, then as Vegas from Crime Wave Coliseum and Goodwood. They race 400 metres now, and Market Link takes up the running clearly. About two lengths on Our Cracker as they swing around the first corner. Cries Le Mirage three lengths away next, and Holy Grail is second behind Market Link, with Cries Le Mirage about three behind Holy Grail. A length behind Cries Le Mirage is Our Cracker, and two lengths to Regal Alliance, another two lengths to Kugel Hopf, one and a quarter then is Vegas, a similar margin, Crime Wave, Coliseum, and last of all is Goodwood as they race to the 1200 marker. And Market Link in front, pulling against his rider, he's about a length and a half on Holy Grail. Three lengths away third is Cries Le Mirage, and at his girth the outside Our Cracker, about two and a half lengths to Regal Alliance. Goodwood making some headway, followed on the fence past the 1,000 by Zvegas from Kugel Hopf. Crime Wave is second last, and last of all is Coliseum. This is the order as they work their way to the side of the Rosehill Gardens track at the 800 marker, and it's Market Link from Holy Grail, some three lengths away next, Our Cracker from Cries Le Mirage, over on the inside of Our Cracker, and then a gap to Regal Alliance, parked over on the inside of Goodwood from Zvegas, ridden along from Crime Wave Kugel Hopf, and still last of all as they race to the corner Coliseum. 500 metres left to run here, and Market Link really being taken on by Holy Grail. Two lengths to Cries Le Mirage, Our Cracker on his outside, and then another two lengths to Regal Alliance. In the straight past the 300, Holy Grail got to Market Link, and about two and a half lengths to Cries Le Mirage. The rider's gone for the whip on it, but it's still coming home resolutely. Past the 200, Holy Grail hits the front, Cries Le Mirage and Market Link, and then Regal Alliance. Cries Le Mirage can't go on with it. Holy Grail in front, Cries Le Mirage having a late lunge out wide, but it will be Holy Grail. Holy Grail from a tight finish, wide out Cries Le Mirage, Market Link on the inside, and then came Regal Alliance, followed by Zvegas, Our Cracker Coliseum, and the last trio were Goodwood, Kugel Hopf and Crime Wave. Stand by for placings. After race number six today, the Aussie Home Loans handicap. Holy Grail, number three, written by D. Beasley. Cries Le Mirage and Market Link fought out the miners. No numbers up. Holy Grail at $6 a win and $2.10 the place in the Star Thoroughbred colours for owners Ms. Dubs Val Smith and Gay Waterhouse, I. Morris, G. Ebbick, Mrs. I. Wilson, J. Narodowski, T. J. Tomic, and Mrs. S. K. Marker by Zabil from Olga's Pal has had the three runs back prior to today and start 23, win number four. Three the winner, Holy Grail, Danny Beasley. Second goes to number four, Cries Le Mirage, ridden by Glenn Boss. Has paid $1.60. And third to number five, Market Link, ridden by Michael Squires, has paid $3.30. 3, 4, 5, and number eight was the official fourth place getter there. And the horse in question, Regal Alliance. 10.70 Quinella, $31 exacta. 156.50 trifecta, $654. And a few cents to add on for the first four, and 80 cents, $654 and 80 cents. Holy Grail, proving it.
The 1600 metre gates, light is on, racing. Brodance missed it a length and a half down nearer the inside, and Ask the Phantom dropped out. Biggs first out from runs on Ego Garcon Bleu, getting up on the inside Western Circle from a Kiwi Bay Super Crest. Garcon Bleu caught wide and he has to ease back. Two to Ask the Phantom, and last of all Brodance. Runs on Ego from the outside, crosses over, leads just over a length now to Western Circle. Three quarters third, the outside would have been Biggs. One for the back, Supercrest. A Kiwi Bay's gone up fifth, one off the fence, two to Ask the Phantom. It's got up on the inside of Garcon Bleu, and three last of all, Brodance. An even speed down the back now. Western Circle on the inside got its neck in front of Runs on Ego, who's outside it. Two lengths to Supercrest third. Fourth is Biggs, the outside at the 1,000. A length and a half then to Ask the Phantom. Fifth on the inside of Okiwi Bay. Two to Garcon Bleu and three last of all Brodance. Turning off the back at the 850 metre mark and Western Circle as they slow a little in front. Move nearly a length to Runs on Ego. Three quarters Supercrest. Fourth the outside Biggs. A length and a half Ask the Phantom. Only about four lengths off them. Locked inside Okiwi Bay. A length further back, Garcon Bleu pushing up in the middle, and two to Brodance last of all. 600 to go. Runs on Ego going up to Western Circle. Biggs is pulling on the outside up three deep. A length and a half Ask the Phantom, shuffle back inside Supercrest. Okiwi Bay went around Garcon Bleu when they turned for home. home in the straight, 400 to go. Western Circle on the inside, coming at it. Biggs quickly, who put its head in front. Western Circle's gone, pushing through again, runs on Ego and a Kiwi Bay down the outside. Garçon Bleu trying to get out from Ask the Phantom, back on the rail. Biggs got its head in front of runs on Ego. Two lengths, so Kiwi Bay and Garçon Bleu. Biggs has drawn three quarters in front with 150 to go. Garçon Bleu gets out, goes after it, but Biggs will find the line. And Biggs has got home a half length on the line to Garçon Bleu. O'Kiwi Bay just got third. From further back is Ask the Phantom, followed on the inside by Runs on Ego, then Super Crest, and back at the tail is Western Circle, bar one, Brodance last of all.
Winner there, 7 Biggs, P. Mertens, 10.90 the win, 2.80 for the place, 3 Garçon Bleu, $1.50, third 9 O'Kiwi Bay, $2.10. 7.39 official. Let's look at the update for the next to Doomben. 1 Just Or, 7.3. 2 Arantel, 20.
Start. Tennant's clearing the back of the stalls. Starter's on his stand, just waiting for the signal from the stewards. They look to be standing very well here at the top of the straight. A very big crowd in attendance at Rockhampton. There's the red light blinking away. Director Special is the favourite just in advance of Regal Touch. Standby. Racing in the Cup of 2001 got them away to an excellent start too. Skymaker showing some early dash from Ned's Revenge, and going up towards the lead in the early part of the race was Growing Concern. Regal Touch is working over from outside barrier to work into a prominent spot early. Nothing's Over Anxious to lead, but here's another off cut. He's cutting up on the outside then taking on Princess Nadeem for the lead. Running down with about 75 metres to the winning post on the first occasion, and the speed will be true. It's another off cut leading from Princess Nadeem, then came Skymaker. The next horse then was Growing Concern. Regal Touch, it's caught out three wide as they turn out of the straight. On its inside there was Party King, and hugging the fence was Ned's Revenge. Getting in behind them then, the next horse there was Casual Creole. Master Raider is just worse than midfield, followed then by Director Special, who's travelling nice and relaxed to Bolse, was next. Pharos Ruler was second to last, and last of all at the tail of the field as they swing around the back of the straight was Rocket Ball. Now the speed is still intense, where it's still another off-cut leading the way, but he slows them from Princess Nadeem. Now Regal Touch has got into a nice spot, up running third. They're followed then by Sky Maker, is keeping it two out. The next horse then was a Growing Concern, followed further back in the field by Ned's Revenge, and Party King was deep. Taking off was Tobolsk. Master Raider is patiently ridden, being followed further back by Casual Creole. He's only got two behind him, Director Special, but he's still travelling okay. They're going to be followed last by Pharos Ruler, and Rocket Ball was just in front of him. Another off-cutter slowed the speed once again when they range up with about 800 metres to go. He leads from Princess to Diem, followed then by going around them to Tobolsk. The next horse was Skymaker, travelling nicely on the rail. Under a little bit of pressure there was Regal Touch, being followed very wide on the track by Growing Concern. Further back in the field then we can see Ned's Revenge, then came Party King. Master Raiders working into it nicely. Where's Director Special? He's got a wall of horses in front of him, and tailed right off was Pharos Ruler. They swing into the stretch here, and up on the outside, ranging up towards them out wide, was Growing Concern. Skymaker's dashed through along the rail. Director Special's coming to the outside at the right time with Master Raider. It's Skymaker hugging the fence. Director Special down the outside's out after him. Skymaker's in front. Master Raider and Director Special, they're hard to line up. Skymaker in front in the closing stages. Skymaker. Skymaker's won the cup for the locals from Master Raider and Director Special, followed home then by Growing Concern and Regal Touch, who failed to run on. The next horse was Party King. Then came another off-cut, and Pharos Ruler. Princess Nadeem was next. Well back in the field was Rocket Ball, Casual Creole, and Tobolsk was tailed off. And the locals have done it with Skymaker, ridden by Jason Taylor. He won the Brisbane Cup on Monday, and he claims the Rockhampton Cup today.
Yeah, Jason Taylor, the Cup's king of the Queensland jockeys, at least currently, winning on Skymaker. Master Raider second, Director Special third, numbers 8-3-2, and that is hot on the heels of Jason's Brisbane Cup win on Star Covet. Now, Doomben Race 6, Just Or 7.50, Erentel 16, Madison 3.20, Twin Fortune.
Late Erogenous number 9. Now, we have Cassie at a move up with Erogenous and Comic Intruder. Previous to Holy Grail, number 3, Dan Beasley, beat 4, Chrysler Mirage, and 5, Market Link in a very close finish. Number 8, fourth. Other winners have been Lady of Letters, King View, Freedom Fighter, London Eye, and Storm Force won the first. Now, the last horses to move in will be Comic Intruder and also Erogenous. A little bit of a problem, however, with a horse drawn towards the middle of the line, because both clerks of the course have come round the front and they've opened the... one of the attendants has opened the front of the boxes And Cassia has come out. They've taken Cassia out the front. Ryder is standing at the back of the stalls. We'll have news on Cassia coming up in just a moment, I'd say. So still three away. Now, what's going to happen here with Cassia? The rider going across towards her, John Grisdale, but she rears and she's flipped over backwards, Cassia.
And she's
up,
and
she's a late scratching. Thank you, Mr. Kelly. Thank you. So Cassia is out at 3:40. She was going to be scratched even before the backflip. So number five, Cassia, is out 3:40 Eastern time. Number five, a late scratching here, Cassia. Yes, I took her out the front, and Kim Kelly was just about to say, right, she's out. And as he did, she did the backflip. Now, the last goes in Comic Intruder, and we're ready for action in the Harvey Norman series. 1,500. Starter Billy Dale goes onto the stand. Presses the button, they're off. Blue Blood immediately out the back, and Comic Intruder straight to the lead. But don't tell me Papel's going to lead Comic Intruder today. It is. And settling, Papel, three quarters Comic Intruder, who's a born leader. Three lengths to Bull William. A length further back is Jibwa, followed by Life Goes Ono Erogenous on the inside of Refuters. They're under the 1,100. Then the New Zealand mare Dancing Days, a couple there to Moore. And three quarters to Blue Blood. Well, these two leaders have gone berserk at the 1,000. Comic Intruder, Kayleen Gilman, and Papel on the inside of it, Michael Squires. They must lead 12 lengths on Bull William. In fourth position, Jibwa, a length. Life Goes Ono, a length to Erogenous. One and a half Refute around Dancing Days. And a couple to Air Demore around Blue Blood. They work their way down the side of the track and approach the 650. And Papel on the inside is a neck-on Comic Intruder. Ah, some 12 or 15 lengths to Bold William, followed by Jibwa, Erogenous. Life Goes Ono, Dancing Days, Refute, Air Demore. And another two lengths to Blue Blood. Now, how quickly are these two going to come back? Around the corner, Papel about a half length on Comic Intruder, and six lengths to Erogenous, and then another length to Bull William. They're taking fairy-like steps, Papel and Comic Intruder. Little wonder. And past the 200, Erogenous, for whom there's been a lot of support, is the leader. Life Goes Ono challenging, and then Air Demore. But the Max Lees trained mare, Life Goes Ono, swooshed past Erogenous. Air Demore might even get up for second, but as they reach the line, that's an easy one for Life Goes Ono. Life Goes Ono from Air Demore or Erogenous, and then a photo for Ford, Bull William and Dancing Days, followed up by, on the inside, Blue Blood, then Refute, and the last three, Papel and Comic Intruder. Well, they went absolutely crazy in front, and Refute, rather Ojibwa back in the tail end a lot. Well, they had to capitulate, didn't they? Anyway, Life Goes Ono, number four, written by Corey Brown, wins the Harvey Norman series. Number four, Life Goes Ono, 370-150, the late scratching number five, Cassia. So in the last 3 minutes, that was action-packed, with Cassia out at 3:40, and then, of course, seeing the way Papel and Comic Intruder raced out with such a huge lead. 4-6-9-2. Four Life Goes Ono, Corey Brown for Max Lees and the Ruane Menangle Syndicate managed by John Baxter, 370-150. Number six is second, Air Demore, written by Luke Price. And Air Demore has paid a dividend of 320. A number nine, Erogenous Grant Buckley third, has paid 160. Two ran fourth, Dancing Days, the Quinella dividend, $25.50, exact of $33. The 3 and a 4 daily double, $22.50. The trifecta, $235.10. And the first four, 4-6-9-2, $752.80. The time was 1 minute 30.46. And the sectional run was 36.93. And here's the winner returning. It turned out an absolute treat. She looked a picture in the yard and she raced right up to it. The Max Lees trained Life Goes Ono. Okay, there's not much more we could add there. Well, those two...